Mrs. C.M. Winkler, and this is my husband, Colonel Winkler. We met during the war, during the 1860s, in Richmond, Virginia, when he was bivouacked there with the members of Hood's Texas Brigade. He was wounded at Gettysburg, but he was one of the few men that came out at Appomattox from Corsicana. After the war, we got married and we came and settled here. And I love this place. This cemetery is very special to me. It's always green with flowers blooming in the springtime, summertime, and spring and fall. You see, I'm actually buried at El Paso, so it's nothing but dust and dirt there. During our time together, I published a book called Hood's Texas Brigade in the Confederate Capital and the Prairie Flower Periodical. I did this to help raise money for the old soldiers that fought for the Confederacy. My heart belonged to them. They had great hopes at one time to make a new nation. My husband, when he came to Texas, he had to fight Indians. And he'll be here in May to tell you some stories about his Indian fights, some time that he spent down in the legislature in Austin. Austin is actually where he died at, and we brought him and buried him here. This cemetery was full of people on that day. When we heard that the Navarro County Genealogical Society was going to hold an odyssey through Oakwood, we were so excited. I decided to come and get ready for company. I think we need some flowers. You know, us Southern ladies, we want to put flowers at the cemetery and decorate our graves. I'm thinking Easter lilies are the red lilies. They're my favorite. They should be real pretty during that time period. When Colonel Winkler comes out to talk to y'all, he'll give you a lot of good stories, I'm sure. You do not want to miss it. So I think I will go get me some lilies, and the Colonel and I will be here on May the 10th. We hope to see you here.
My name is L.C. Cook, and I want to tell you all a bit about the oil wells in Powell, Texas. The Corsicana Deep Well Oil Company started drilling in Powell in 1919. The first couple of attempts failed, but finally in January of 23, they done struck oil. By July, there were 17 wells operating, and by August, the Powell oil field alone was putting out more oil than the next 10 oil-producing states combined. But all that success happened later. It's really the 8th of May in 1923 I want to talk to y'all about. I was working with the boys on the J.K. Hughes Mackey No. 1. Y'all know where it is? On the east bank of Chambers Creek. It was about a mile from the Discovery Well and was the biggest dang producer the company owned. It just came in the day before with over 8,000 barrels. Most of us boys are about the same age, in our early 30s, and most of us had wives and kids. I lived in Powell, some of us from Kearns, and the rest pretty much lived in Corsicana. Well, y'all want to know what happened that day? I know. A little before 2 in the afternoon, one of the boys, I ain't sure which one, come up to the casing and put a control valve alongside of it. As he was doing this, his hammer struck a rock. There was a spark, such as a boy might make when he cracks two rocks together, building an Indian fire. More of a flame y'all ever did see, as the fire, the oil, and the gas all came together at once. I remember the spark, the noise, and the heat. That's all. I knowed in a split second that we was all done for. The flame shot 100 feet in the air. They say the black smoke could be seen clear across the county in Hubbard. Y'all see, as the oil kept coming, it kept igniting. And there were about 1,000 barrels of what we call waste oil that caught fire too. Everything around it was on fire. Trees, bushes, sheds, automobiles, everything, because most of it was soaked with oil from before. The boss been tried to put the fire out with steam boilers and dynamite, but this weren't no easy thing to do. It weren't till 12 days later that they finally got old number one turned off. I lost a lot of my friends with me, 13 of us in all, good men, hard-working men, men who laid their lives down for others, and that's just what they did, and I'd hate for them to be forgotten.
Thank you. Did you know that Dr. Dan Hamill was sometimes perceived as a very gruff and grouchy person, but by his co-workers and patients, they knew a completely different person, and that is the person I would like to share with you. From the time that he was a little boy, Dan Hamill knew he wanted to be a doctor, and he grew up to be a passionate, caring, gentle doctor, not only to his own patients, but to the patients of other doctors. And not only was he the doctor, but he spent time in the community, active in our city affairs such as politics, charities, his civic duties. And while he was doing that, he was a teacher, a trainer, and the young doctors of Corsicana looked up to Dr. Dan Hamill. In fact, his expertise were so well renowned that sometimes he was requested outside our city for special surgeries, which he would fly to. A fun fact about him is that when he would go into the delivery rooms to deliver the babies, he would wear a pink shoe on one foot and a blue shoe on the other. In fact, some of the residents today of Corsicana were actually delivered by Dr. Dan Hamill. In my personal opinion, I don't believe there is a more dedicated doctor to his profession than that can be found in Dr. Dan Hamill.
Hello, my name is Lee Murray. I'm president of the Navarro County Genealogy Society, and I want to welcome you to Oakwood Cemetery in Corsicana, Texas. This is an old cemetery dating from the 1800s, with the first burial being in 1852. In conjunction with the Liz Gillispie Genealogy Department of Corsicana Public Library, we're going to present for you a wonderful event called Oakwood Odyssey. The Odyssey is a walking tour of around 9 graves of past citizens of Navarro County and the city of Corsicana. You will encounter, led by docents, you will encounter speaking in first person actors portraying the lives of these people that are buried in these 9 graves. You will see and hear what their lives were about. Very enjoyable experience if you will come and visit with us. Come and call the Corsicana Public Library at 903-654-4808 to book your tours. The tours are on Saturday, May 10th, 2014, beginning at 5:30 p.m. and the last tour beginning at 8:30 p.m. There are 6 tours per hour. We ask that you wear comfortable walking shoes and carpool if possible. The prices are $10 per ticket. We hope that you will come and bring a group of friends with you and enjoy our tour at Oakwood Odyssey. We hope to see you there.